And done. Oh, hey, scientist. Welcome back. Sorry, I'm a little distracted. I've been super into puzzles lately. I just love how the small pieces combine to create a complete picture. Are you a puzzler too? Wait, what do you mean it looks like there's a puzzle in my puzzle? Oh yeah, it does kind of look like South America would perfectly fit into the west coast of Africa, but how could two continents with an entire ocean between them fit like puzzle pieces? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain plate tectonics. Let's investigate. You know, I'm still puzzled by this. The longer I look, the more Earth's continents or large pieces of land like Asia and North America look like they'd fit together. Can you help me with this, scientists? Along with your guided notes, I've added a version of my world map puzzle just for you. Pause the video and cut out each continent piece or scan the QR code to move the continents digitally. Can you try to fit them all together like a puzzle? What did you notice? Even though it wasn't a perfect fit, I was able to fit all my pieces together into one big piece of land. Super strange, right? Well, there just might be an explanation. A long, long time ago, the continents were all connected. Scientists believe that instead of being all spread out like they are today, the continents were once grouped together as one big piece of land. Instead of having separate continents like Europe and Australia, there was just one. We call this continent Pangaea, meaning all Earth. But how can that be? How did the Earth go from one big continent to very separate ones? The land that we call continents are part of the hard rocky crust that makes up the outer layer of the Earth. That rock can't just move. Can it? Scientists, can you think of any examples of when the ground beneath our feet moves? Ooh! Whoa! All right, earthquakes! Thank you for the reminder, Mia, but maybe you could be a little more subtle next time. Hey, maybe earthquakes hold the key to understanding how the continents spread apart. During an earthquake, the ground shakes and shifts. But how could solid rock shake? Scientists were confused about this too, so they began to track earthquakes. When they did that, they noticed something interesting. In some places, earthquakes almost never happen, and in others, they happen again and again. They recorded where earthquakes happened on a map, and it looked like this. What do you notice about this earthquake map? It looks just like a puzzle, right? Scientists realized the Earth's crust isn't one solid piece of rock. Instead, it's broken into pieces called tectonic plates. The lines formed where we see a lot of earthquakes are actually the places where different plates meet, called plate boundaries. But how does the crust being broken into plates cause earthquakes? Well, let's think about what lies beneath. What do we know about the mantle? The top of the mantle is made of hot, molten rock. Imagine trying to float a cracker on top of a bubbling pot of soup. Would it stay still? No. Just like the bubbling soup would move the cracker, the heat from the mantle causes the tectonic plates to move. So why don't we feel the plates moving all the time? Well, the movement of tectonic plates is super slow. So slow that these giant pieces of crust only move a few centimeters each year. That's about as fast as your fingernails grow. It's happening all the time, but it's so slight that we don't notice it day to day. But sometimes, when two plates press against each other at a plate boundary, they can get stuck. The plates keep trying to move, but another plate is in their way, and this causes a buildup of a lot of pressure at the boundary, and eventually, boom! The plates slip, and all that energy gets released in the form of an earthquake. That's when we feel the ground shake. So even though we only feel it on rare occasions, we know the plates are always slowly moving. Think back to our puzzle from earlier. We were wondering how continents that are separated by oceans today could have once fit together. Based on what we know about tectonic plates, how do you think the continents could have moved over time? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. It was the movement of the tectonic plates over an extremely long period of time that caused the continents to drift apart. That's what scientists call continental drift, the idea that the plates, including the continents, are always moving. Slowly, the land masses broke away from Pangaea and ended up where they are today. And the plates are still moving, so who knows how different the world map may look millions of years from now. Maybe one day we'll have a whole new puzzle to solve. Let's review everything we've learned today. Earth's crust is broken up into large pieces called tectonic plates. The plates are always moving extremely slowly because of the heat from the mantle. Scientists believe the movement of the tectonic plates is the cause of continental drift, the slow shifting of continents over a long period of time. To learn more about plate tectonics, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Science really is like a puzzle. We take small pieces of evidence and fit them together to understand the bigger picture. Ta-da! Hey, do tectonic plates have anything to do with how mountains are formed? Something to think about for next time. Until then, keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time! Hey!